The investigation of this matter was not done in a credible and trustworthy fashion, and the failure to do that segues into a not trustworthy and not credible presentation of this case to you by the prosecutor. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there are several glaring examples of that that have occurred in this trial. A picture of what appears to be a finished bathroom in Troy Manero's home. This is the first picture that the prosecution opted to show you. Why is this significant, ladies and gentlemen? Because during cross-examination, what did we learn about this picture? We learned 5-6 weeks ago that this is the downstairs bathroom in Troy Manero's house. And the work that was done on a bathroom in Troy Manero's house was the upstairs bathroom. And we learned that this bathroom was never even worked on by anyone, that this bathroom, the downstairs bathroom, was in this condition when Troy Manero bought the house. Now, why do I bring this up right at the beginning of my summation? Think about why they showed you this. They didn't show you this just to put up a non-dump bathroom because it looks new. It looks like it was just recently tiled, because maybe that's the way the sun was shining on it, I don't know. But the facts are, no work was done in this bathroom. They presented that to you, ladies and gentlemen, to impact you, to try to convince you that this is the work that was done by DPW workers. We showed you that this tile work, which is the only evidence in this case that exists, that Mr. Longo did work on the tile of the bathroom, occurred during that period of time. Now, ladies and gentlemen, why did the prosecution not show you that? Because they wanted to take a fact and shrink a fact and shade the fact down so it fit to their theory of the case. Because the whole fact did not fit their theory of the case. That's why it was so important for them to show you that this work was done in May of 2010 rather than June, by putting up these photographs that don't mean anything, to try to get you thinking in that direction. That is not the way you present the case. That is not presenting a case with integrity and credibility when you're trying to achieve justice, when you have people's lives on the line. Very important issue. It's literally trying to hang on Mr. Longo, Mr. Venero, that they worked in elections. Elections they have no interest in, that they don't know who the candidates are, that they can care less. They're trying to hold them privily responsible for that. Yet the two people that would have an interest in that, the two people that would benefit from that, particularly Mr. Nick Sacco, the mayor, because he's an elected official, and Mr. Frank Ardule, an elected official, did they even ask them what they knew about it? Ladies and gentlemen, don't you think that's who you'd want to go ask the question to? The people that were benefiting from it and say to them, hey, how did this happen? Why did it happen? What kind of orders came down? What kind of pressure was put on these people? Not only did they do it, but it was not done through incompetence or stupidity or negligence on their part. They made a calculated decision not to do it. If you remember, I asked Joe Salvatore, I said, Mr. Salvatore, geez, did he even go ask Sacco if he was aware that all these soldiers in town were working on the election? Did he ask Ardulo? You remember what his response was? He said, well, we thought about it and we discussed it and we made a decision not to do it.